Golden State Warriors, a team that's getting a lot of attention in Vegas right now with the NBA playoffs. And speaking of sports gambling, according to the Nevada Gaming Commission, last year alone there was $1.8 billion placed on football bets, $1.5 billion on basketball, and $1.1 billion on baseball. For the last 25 years, Las Vegas and the state of Nevada has had sports gambling all to itself. But the time has come for Sin City to share the wealth.
First and goal, handoff, C.J. Anderson, a left guard into Kuechly. Second effort to the goal line, touchdown Denver.
The Professional and Amateur Sports Protection Act, or PAPSA, established in 1992, made it illegal to gamble on sports anywhere in the U.S. except Nevada. The law made the Las Vegas Sportsbook a national commodity. If you wanted to bet on a game, the only place you could legally do it was Nevada. But it won't be that way for much longer. The Supreme Court just gave the go-ahead to legalize sports betting nationwide.
The Supreme Court ruling this past week indicated that they're going to defer to the states in terms of what their laws and rules are in terms of sports gambling. So for each of the states, you have to go and look at what the existing laws are. And then if states decide that they do want to have sports gambling and they don't today, they need to take action in order to make that happen.
Four states have already passed legislation. 18 more have introduced legislation. Colorado hasn't made any moves because it's a little more complicated here.
From Colorado, we've got two different answers. The first one is in Title 18 of the Colorado Revised Statutes, it actually specifically prohibits sports gambling. It makes sports gambling illegal. So the first thing that would need to take place is the legislature would actually have to change that prohibition. The second one is constitutional related. So it's possible that we would also require a constitutional change, which would require a vote of the people.
Sounds like it might be a while before you're throwing down cold hard cash on a Broncos game up in Blackhawk.
How long realistically would it be before people really could place bets in Colorado?
It would probably be, I would imagine, 18 to probably 24 months, maybe 32 months. So probably still quite some time in terms of getting legislation passed and the initiative passed.
If sports betting gets the green light in Colorado, it'll likely start out in the three mountain towns where infrastructure's already in place: Blackhawk, Central City, and Cripple Creek.
We believe that voters have spoken repeatedly that they like to keep gambling in those three mountain communities. Every time there's been an attempt to allow gambling outside of the mountain communities, it's failed miserably. Anywhere from 68 to 90% failure rate. Folks like the idea of gambling limited up in the mountains, not in their backyard, not on the street corner, not adding transportation woes, not adding concerns with what might be going on. They like it in the mountain towns where it's in a confined area.
Whether or not sports gambling stays in the three mountain towns or expands throughout the state is to be seen. For now, it's all a waiting game. But that's not always a bad thing.
At this moment, where's Colorado stand on this?
I don't know that we have an answer at this point. I think that we really do need the legislature to tell us. Because Title 18 specifically outlaws sports betting at this point in time, today we can't do anything and we would not be able to participate regardless of what the recent Supreme Court ruling was. But if the legislature feels that this is the time to change that policy and that law, then I think it's a good debate to have and one that we would follow their direction on.
It's time to wait, see what the other guys do, and then figure it out.
I think taking time to learn lessons from others is always a good thing.
Now, the NBA has already said they want a 1% integrity fee on the bets. The MLB is right behind them. The NFL, on the other hand, has long opposed the legalization of sports gambling. But I bet once Roger Goodell sees the revenue potential, the NFL will be all in.